welcome to Wildhorse Park on this beautiful fall morning, and welcome to the ribbon cutting of this beautiful new playground and trail system that you see behind us. We're here to mark one of the most desirable, what Al? No, about as far as it's gonna go. One of the most desirable assets and amenities that was identified in our master plan, and those are playgrounds. That was the highest priority that came out of our master plan, and you're seeing those results behind us. Another high priority identified in our master plan is trail connections. And you also see these trail connections now from our neighborhood over to retail and grocery stores and connections to Shaw Middle School as well. So to learn more about this project and the importance to our city, I want to welcome our mayor, Mayor Woodward.
Thank you, Garrett, and what a beautiful day to celebrate the latest improvement in one of our beautiful parks. We are a city blessed with many, many parks, and so thankful for our park board and everything that they do to keep our parks safe, active spaces, because that's what we want in our city. We want to be able to activate our parks so that they become safe places for families and for children to enjoy and recreate. And the improvements made at this park are now going to benefit this entire community. And this is the third ribbon cutting that we're doing in 3 weeks to improve our parks, activate our parks, and make them beautiful assets in our neighborhoods. So thank you for everything Parks is doing. The master plan is doing exactly what it's supposed to do. And we're very, very fortunate in our city to be able to have these parks and their connections to neighborhoods and to businesses and their surroundings. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Mayor, for the kind words. And as always, thank you for your support. Next up is our Park Board President, Bob Anderson.
I may need to meet Laura for a short guy. Just kidding. All right. Good morning, and thank you for choosing to spend part of this beautiful Friday morning with us. Today, even Mother Nature agrees at this Wildhorse Park playground opening by providing this beautiful day for us. For the Spokane community, October 20th, 2023 represents another step towards our Healthy Parks, Healthy Neighborhoods initiative, and it follows earlier renovations at Liberty and Grants Park. So why now for Wildhorse Park? I suppose some in the community would question, what took you so long? But the answer to both questions is one we all understand: dreams versus financial reality. Since I started on the park board in 2018, we have listened to so many neighborhood parks' dreams, with the sad reality we didn't always have the funds to make them come true. So what's changed? The city of Spokane has received funds from the American Rescue Plan, FEMA, and other grants. Our city council, responsible for allocating those funds, listened to you, the Spokane community, and when you told them parks are important to you, they allocated $1.2 million for playgrounds and other improvements in our neighborhood parks. Spokane Parks found a way to combine those funds with other grants to renovate the three chosen parks. So what has changed at Wildhorse Park? A new 3,000 square foot playground aimed at ages 3 to 12 years old. Equipment including a saucer swing, rope climbers, tree house, and swaying cattails. Several new shade trees, 6-foot concrete walks, and the 10-foot asphalt trail connecting the park to the Children of the Sun Trail and downtown Hilliard. And looking at that one, what a wonderful addition. And now my favorite part, giving to thanks to so many who helped make this dream come true. $291,000 total cost for design and construction, was funded in large part by the American Rescue Plan funds allocated by the City Council, the Hilliard Neighborhood Council, led by Joe Carter and Luke Tolley, who reviewed and provided feedback on the design, our contractors, All Star Systems, Bacon Concrete, Bernardo Wills Architects, Kaufman Engineers, Rock Mountain Design and Construction, Parks Planning Team, Park Operations, Urban Forestry, and the members of our Park Board. So what's next? On October 12th, the Park Board passed a resolution requesting our City Council to place a Parks Master Plan-driven Investing in Our Neighborhoods levy request on the February ballot. As it should be, the future of Spokane Parks will be decided by you, the Spokane community. In closing, I have read most of the 54 Google reviews posted to Wildhorse Park, and I appreciate the common theme they reflect. Our park doesn't have everything we want, but it is ours, and we are happy to have it. So today we've added the much requested new playground, and we hope if you allow us to return later and add more to your park. Thank you.
Thank you, Bob. As always, a great speech. And I do also want to thank the Park Board as a whole for their continued support. And we have Jennifer Ogden here as well today from our Park Board. And next up is another big piece of this partnership in our City Council as well that represents District 1, that is Councilmember Michael Cathcart.
Yeah, thank you. Well, I get to pinch hit for Councilmember Bingle, who is out ill today, unfortunately. But boy, this is just wonderful to have this investment. It's really bright here. It's wonderful to have this investment in the neighborhood here. And I know that there are so many kids in the neighborhood that utilize this park. I was out here probably 6 or 8 weeks ago now, knocking on doors, talking to neighbors, and I couldn't tell you how many times I heard from people who were asking, when's the park going to be done? Our children love that park. They want to go back to that park. And so this is really, really important to have this done and to have these nice amenities for our kids to play. And it's been mentioned a couple of times, but I just think it's really important to reiterate that the fact that, you know, you're going to be able to go from the Northeast Community Center, from Shaw, take the trail or take the sidewalk, get on the trail and come to this park. You can keep going and go to Minnehaha Park. You know, if you're downtown Hilliard, we're going to see hopefully some really awesome activating of downtown Hilliard soon with a bicycle shop and things like that. People are going to be able to rent those bikes, take the Children of the Sun Trail right here and utilize this space. And that is just a wonderful amenity, I think, for Northeast and for this community. And again, I mean, improving the playgrounds at all of our parks is really important. And that's why, obviously, the council and the Parks Board have made this a priority. And it was mentioned on the future levy, and obviously we're going to be getting some more information on that soon and potentially putting that on a ballot. And it's really important that folks have the opportunity to improve their parks and improve these open green spaces that really just makes these neighborhoods so much healthier and better to live in. So congratulations to the Park Board. Congratulations to all the folks who actually made this possible, the workers, the engineers, designers. Just thank you all for the time and effort that you put in. So, thank you.
Well, thank you, Council Member. And again, there's one common theme to all of this, and it's really around that collaboration. I think there's one thing we can all agree on. Investing in our community open spaces is a top priority. That capital improvement creates that positive activation, which creates that ownership in our neighborhoods that create a safe neighborhood for our families and youth. So, with that, I would like to invite our speakers and then as well as Jennifer up to the front here to cut the ribbon in a little countdown from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, congratulations. Let's play.